Yeah. So guys, we're back again, and I think it's been some time since I did this one. We're going to be making a beat breakdown, project review, or how I did a certain track. So this time I decided to check out this Black Coffee Drive remix I did, and a lot of people love this track. Uploaded a sample on Twitter, and I even got some few fire emojis from Black Coffee himself. So the track is not so bad, obviously. I also uploaded it on my other channel, so you can listen it to it there, and plenty more other channels uploaded the same track. So yeah, this is it. So I don't know where I'm gonna start. Okay, this is the whole project, and the thing is, I don't think I'll be able to play the whole drive a cappella because of copyright issues and stuff. So I'll just be playing a few chops. For example, here. This is my intro. Yeah, I'm going to start with this vocal. This is a vocal chop from the original a cappella. So I just chopped out this part, and then I made it unique, so I sent it to a different mixer channel. And I just cut out low frequencies, as you can see my EQ. Exactly. So if there was no let me close these effects. I can't go fast enough. As you can hear, so low frequencies, I put a lot of delay and some reverb too. And then next, I have this up. I love this one also. This follows the whole track progression, but for this intro part, I just decided to play those same few keys, but later on, as we change it, yeah, this shit is dope, man. GMS, crash keys. And then also I my automated pad right here. Morphine. sharp as the track progresses. This thing plays a huge role, but I'm not sure if you can easily understand. What else? I think this is just a bass. This one, I'm not sure if the loudness is okay. Volume should have been a bit upper, or plus I also killed I don't know. Next, okay, and melodies. Everyone already knows this one because I use it a lot. And the trick is about these melodies, they're not the same, because I'm sure that as you can see, this is not the same as this one. I changed it after some time. I think the trick is when I changed these melodies was at this, like after the chorus, I think. So there was that bit of, I don't know what to call this thing, relaxation, because we just passed the chorus, after chorus, so verse 2 or something. It's so busy. This sounds ish. I think this is like the main ish of the track. Keeps the rhythm flowing. Trance step. Point out, I played with the cut off. Yeah. part where I'm just about to introduce the drums. So I wanted it for it to open up at the same time the drums kick in. You can hear the drums almost sound. Truly inspired by Blekov, because he used those type of percussions, and also the rim shot, I think. These keys just when it hits the chorus. So everything is just right there at the right moment, that's what I'd say. Because if I played with this. Most of the things I didn't even use here. Not sure about this one. Next, I think okay, I already talked about this chords. This one too. Now I think I have to just cover the drums also. Broken beat was actually the last thing I did on this track. I didn't even use this one. So these drums were made after. Last thing, especially the broken kick. What helped me with this one was this thing. They correspond. Thank you. the build up. I think most of stock plugins, as usual, besides that flute, I think that's the Purity flute. Some automated volume of this thing. Simple, create some build up. Yeah, I think that's almost everything. Yeah. Okay, so guys, if you know any track request you'd like me to show you how I did or what I did, just comment below, or also ask anything about this one. I'll be able to reply to you on the comment section. Yeah, other than that, I've been getting a lot of great feedback for this track. So yeah, thank you. I'll hear from you. For now, let me bounce.